So, let's get started. So first of all, welcome to you all. 79 participants from 13 different countries. My usual graph, my usual fight with Excel last night to get it just right. Do I need to stand right here? No. Right, okay. Yeah, no, I seem to be back. Okay. Of those participants, 18 are from Dyalog. As usual, we bring pretty much everyone here so they can meet with you and you can meet with them. Tell them what you like, what you don't like. And we're here to listen and to do various bits and bobs around. There's also 17 people here that's here for the first time, which I think is sort of a record. So welcome to you all, and I hope it's not the last time we see you. We hope you enjoy the user meeting and get enough home with you that it's worthwhile coming back for more. Of those 17 first timers, we have Jamin Wu, who is the competition winner. Jamin, please get up. Thank you. Jamin will tell us on Thursday how he won the, no, on Wednesday, how he won the competition. But usually people would like to know who it is so they can approach and talk and try and convince the competition winner that this is the lifelong career they've just ended. This year we have one more competition winner. And this is the first time that the non-student competition winner has joined us for the user meeting. So, Torsten, sit up. Welcome. There are also some people we are going to miss. Harriet Neville was signed up for this user meeting, but sadly, on the 23rd of August, she passed away completely unexpectedly. Harriet had a long career in APL and started at IP Sharp Associates in the late 70s, and she was instrumental for the largest APL conference ever held, the 79 one in Rochester. She left IP Sharp and then worked as an independent consultant for many years, Niagara Mohawk and later at Xerox. I sort of met with Harriet and it was an instant liking between us, and so we met with all these conferences that we've been to over the years, and it's funny how these people you work with also becomes your friends, and obviously how much you miss them when they're suddenly not there anymore. There is an obituary page. There's a link here, and you will have access to the slides afterwards, so if you want to contribute or visit that page, and there's also a memorial in October, you can go there. And sadly, it doesn't stop there. On the 18th of February, we lost our genius, gentleman, and mischievous schoolboy, John Scholes. John, as most of you know, was one of the original implementers of Dyalog APL, together with Jeff Streeter. And he kept, in his own word, trying to finish that program that he had started on back in the early 80s. And just weeks before his passing, he finished the Mantis item 16, which was a long-standing inconvenience in the language. He was also the creator of the defense, bridging his first love, APL, with the second love, functional programming. He was an excellent teacher and a mentor for the younger members of our staff. And I haven't seen a devastation like that in the weeks following his passing at the offices at Dyalog. We really, really miss him. He was also a brilliant producer of small APL demos for the web, YouTube, and John's Game of Life is now almost 200,000 views, which is quite exceptional for something as technical as that. There's a memorial page for John, and there's a video section there where we have helped assemble all the bits and pieces he did for YouTube for us. And I mean, you might want to revisit the social skills for programmer, or maybe it's hardware store, or also called a plea for simplicity, the thing about the hammer. That was quite sophisticated. It had us all in tears when he presented it at these user meetings. And so we won't have more of them. But we shall remember him dearly. Oh, and speaking of hammers, after 7 years of snakes and 7 years of ships, we are now entering into 7 years of hammers, I hope. In the Norse mythology, cosmos and chaos were called respectively Innengard and Utengard. So that means within the gods or outside the gods. Asgard was the homeworld of the gods, and Midgard was the home of humanity. And those two together were seen as Innengard, the organized part of the cosmos, while the giants and their worlds, all the unpredictable and uncontrollable items, were seen as Utengard and chaos. Thor is the god controlling the forces of nature. When he drives his cart across the heavens, you know, you see lightning and there's thunder. And he also controls the rain and the fertility of the land. Using his hammer Mjolnir, as the most powerful weapon in Asgard, Thor is fighting a constant battle against chaos and the giants. The hammer always hits its target and it always returns to its owner. But it's also used to consecrate crops or maybe wedding couples or other things, children that's been born, given name as such. So when something or someone is consecrated with Thor's hammer, it was taken from the realm of chaos and absorbed into cosmos, protected from the ill effects of chaos and its denizens, and sanctified and sanctioned by the social order and divine models. And I think that's pretty much what we can do with APL. Bring order into chaos. So, yeah. The giveaways this year, we've gone all ecological, or eco-friendly at least. So it's recycled materials and organic cotton and bamboo fibers, etc., etc. Better to keep on the safe side of the hammer and not mess with nature. So after this meeting, when we get back home, we didn't have the energy to do it before we left, we'll make Dyalog APL available for unregistered non-commercial use. We've previously had an annoying version, but we'll remove that. It sort of popped up every half hour and said it was unregistered and would they not like to register. So the new one will be completely identical to the commercial version, and we'll also remove the educational version because there's no reason to have that. There's really no difference between that and the non-commercial in the future. And why we're doing that is because we really want APL out to young people. And one of the things that happens is that when they get to a place and they have to give you their name, all these big multinationals has made sure that this is not something you want to do lightly. And why should they trust us not to misuse these this information, especially being a commercial company? I mean, disgusting. So we are trying to see if we can actually overcome that obstacle to more young people trying out APL and using it. There is one difference. Version 17.1 will display a message in the session explaining the condition of this particular license, and that's determined from the license number. So it'll tell you whether this is an unregistered version, not to be used for commercial use, or it's a non-commercial version, which means it's registered, not to be used for commercial use. So if you get one of these messages, or God forbid it, one of your customers get one of these non-commercial or unregistered messages, please talk to us, because you probably haven't got your license number in the right place. So the system don't detect that you have actually paid and you are allowed to use it for commercial purposes. We are actually seeing a growing interest in APL among young people. So this step, we think, is the right way. There's another reason why we are doing it, is that Morten wants to put Docker containers on available so that they can just be used, tried out and downloaded. And we can't have these Docker containers, particularly not if you want to scale to like 20 or maybe even 1,000 parallel Docker containers running, that each of them have to be signed into. One of the things we could have done was obviously to go open source ourselves. But we've been thinking long and hard about it, and we think there's two reasons why we can't find a good business model for that. And one is the necessity to keep the APL interpreter consistent. Means that inviting everybody in to contribute to the interpreter itself would either be a fake attempt, or we would have to do a lot of work to make sure that everything was fitting in with what we are providing up front already. And it would make, I don't think with an open source that our efforts to have an identical system across all the different platforms would appeal to an open source crowd. On the other hand, contributions to the tool chain, which has started to happening, and submission of libraries to GitHub, where we have Dyalog libraries, is a completely different matter, and we welcome that very much, the sharing between APL users of tools and good programs to solve different problems in a specific professional area. So we encourage that very much. And we are going to make quite some work to organize what's on GitHub so that it's easy to find. Right now it's a bit of a tumultuous repository, I would say. The second reason is we care about people. And it's really hard to see how we would be able to pay the salaries of the people necessary to maintain the APL interpreter and the support. So, I mean, actually, in our opinion, software development is an honorable profession, and that people should be allowed to work normal hours, not working for free during the night, and be able to raise a family on the salary they are paid for it. Right now, I can't see how we would do that if we went completely open source. But if some of you have ideas, I have not seen examples in the market either that's been really successful with that. And by the way, we do offer a really fair pricing model where young people, entrepreneurs, can test ideas out without paying fees to us, as long as they sign up for a royalty contract. That means that at the point in time where they start earning money, they also pay a fee for Dyalog APL, being 2% of the revenue generated. And I think, I mean, if you don't think you can be more than 2% more efficient using APL, you shouldn't use it. I think it's vastly more productive to use APL if you want to test new ground and make money from that. And the 2% is just a very small addition you have to make to the price you'd have to take anyway. We want to spread the gospel. We are running into these issues about being commercial and young people don't like it, to give their name and all that stuff. So we are trying to mediate all that. But we hope you will help us spread the word. So we made a Viking challenge this year that's directed at this. I won't reveal too much more of that, but I'd like to encourage all of you to turn up to the Viking challenge. There are no strenuous exercises or any hard work or anything, only fun and creative teamwork. So please, on Wednesday at 1 o'clock in this room, you'll get the introduction. Oh, and one final thing, no, two actually. If you see Don Daintree looking a lot at his phone during this conference, it's not because he's unattentive or bored with your presentation. It's because he's blocking from this event. So he's actually doing his job and he's listening even more intensive and to be able to report on it. So tonight here is the last thing. There's an APL team challenge that's managed by Roberto Minervini and his three students. You might start thinking about teaming up with people now. The Viking challenge will be teamed up based on the animals on your batch. So you might want to choose to do that, or you can do it differently tonight. But it might be a good idea to start talking to your peers. You will recognize them when you look at their batch. Oh yeah, and there was the thing about the taxi lists. I mean, if at the end of the thing you want to share a taxi with someone, Fiona has a list where you can sign up when you're going, where you're going. That's just a minor thing. But with that, I hope you'll enjoy Dyalog 19, and I'll hand you over to Morten.